Really? Seems like I got run over by a big bearded tank. Think it was enough for him to sign me? I don't know. But no matter what, you always have a home in the BCW. Thanks.
Hey, I saw a lot of positive things from you tonight. Most importantly, you didn't seem intimidated by being on the bigger stage or by being locked in the cage with a monster. So with that being said, we'd like to offer you an NXT contract. Look that over and return it at tomorrow night's show.
This is amazing. Thank you. I would shake your hand, but I think three of my fingers are dislocated.
Don't worry about it. Rest up and we'll finalize everything tomorrow night.
You did it. I'm shocked. Me too. I just can't believe it. I mean, against all odds.
I know.
I'll definitely be sad to see you go. You've become one of my top guys.
You'll be fine, though, right? You got Cole and the rest of the crew, yeah?
Sorry, what am I doing? This is your time to celebrate, not to worry about me and BCW. You enjoy the moment. I'm going to go talk to Triple H about when you might start, so maybe I can get you on one more BCW show. We'll do a big farewell match. It'll be great.
Sounds good.
I'll see you back at the hotel. Congrats. I'm proud of you.
Thanks, Baron. Couldn't have done without you.
Actually, I was literally just offered an NXT contract, and I can't wait to get started. You should just skip NXT and go straight to the main roster. Actually, you know what? Hey, Triple H, you say listen to your audience? Well, the audience is saying that I'm good enough to go straight to the main roster, which actually, I think I proved it tonight by going toe-to-toe with Braun Strowman in a steel cage and not backing down, but... tonight by going toe-to-toe with Braun Strowman in a steel cage and not backing down, but...
Less than 24 hours after we offer you the opportunity of a lifetime, you get into a fight with a fan outside a WWE event, and there's video. I'd really love to hear this explanation.
The fan attacked me first. I was just defending myself. What am I supposed to do? Just stand there and get beat up?
All we can see is you fighting with a member of the WWE Universe, and that's not good.
Well, that's how it happened.
You need to understand, this isn't some...
Wake up game, man. Relax.
You might want to choose a less terrifying wrestler name next time.
Yeah, noted. We made it.
Already? It really didn't seem like we were driving 2 days.
Gee, I wonder why. It's because you've been asleep the entire 2 days.
Hey, I need my genius promoter rest.
Mm-hmm.
How do you say I need a shower in Spanish?
Necesito un shower? I don't know. I don't remember the word for shower.
You're a lot of help.
Did you see that?
What?
That masked guy who attacked me, he's here. I just saw him.
I think you're seeing things from being awake for so long.
I'm telling you, that was him.
How about you get some rest before your big match tonight? We need to keep all our momentum going. Can't have any setbacks due to hallucinations.
That wasn't a hallucination.
All right.
Wait! Stop! Pull over!
What? What is it? Did you see him?
No! I want to try some authentic Mexican street corn.
You're the worst.
Thank you.
don't know why you're doing this, but I am not gonna let you try to ruin my career ever again.
Lo siento. Soy un fan y solo quería atención. Perdóname, por favor.
What you saying? Did you admit to everything?
He's a fan. Just craving attention. He's a copycat. It's not the same guy. Let him go.
Gracias, señor. Oye, ¿puedo tener un autógrafo?
Not tonight, buddy.
Well, your big Mexico debut didn't go quite as planned, but the match was still great up until the end. Any publicity is good publicity, right? You still got the buzz going.
I guess. I'll take a shower.
You mean ducha? I looked it up.
I'd say it's more beast than beauty.
The official name is the Scrap Trap. Not only are we going to have our biggest streaming audience yet, we're doing it in one of WWE's most iconic venues. It's like we're invading their territory. Man, I wish I could see the look on Triple H's face when he sees this.
Where did this even come from? Where did you dig this up?
All over. I salvaged it from other wrestling promotions, a junkyard scrap. That section is from WCW's Triple Cage. That is from an ECW cage. And I believe that side used to be an old prison fence. Pretty neat, huh?
I think a better name would be Death Trap. This violates every health code known to mankind.
Yeah, it does. But I'm afraid I got some bad news.
What? Yeah, what happened?
Our pay-per-view stream went down in the middle of your match. No one watching online got to see how it ended.
Did the site crash or something? What happened?
No, we were taken down intentionally by Triple H.
Triple H? How can he even do that?
He and WWE's lawyers are claiming they have exclusive rights to broadcast from this venue.
Damn it!
And now we're getting flooded with refund requests. Don't think you're getting any bonus checks for this show, guys. I'm sorry.
Does either of you know if you can return slightly used jet skis? I might have jumped the gun on purchasing a couple. We'll circle back to that later. First, Triple H unfairly pulls my contract up from an attack, and now he's trying to sabotage our business? We have to strike back.
They have a team of lawyers and an endless supply of cash. You guys just competed in a cage made from an old prison fence. What could we possibly do to them?
Well, you said it earlier. Tonight was like we're invading their territory, right? So, what if we actually did that?
What do you mean?
I mean, we hit Triple H exactly where it hurts the most by selling him used jet skis. Invading NXT! Invading NXT! Totally on the same page as you, Buzz.
I don't know about this, guys. It seems risky.
Why? We've both been rejected by WWE, so what do we have to lose, right? And this is what you wanted, Baron. You wanted this. You said it yourself. Our plan was to stick it to Triple H. So what do you say?
I think we're gonna need a really big stick.
That's what I'm talking about! Front row, just like you wanted.
This is your electric bill.
Oh, sorry. Wrong pocket.
This is it, Buzz. You ready?
Oh, I'm ready. fighting. You guys remember when Triple H and DX invaded WCW? People still talk about that to this very day. This is going to be very good for us and BCW.
Just be ready for anything.
I'll be pulling for you.
I was thinking...
jump someone tonight to really make an impact,
but I trust your judgment.
When you don't want to miss it, Velveteen Dream takes on Adam Cole, and what is sure to be...
Sorry to interrupt, Michael, but something's going on in the crowd.
Wait, I recognize those two. Isn't that...
Hey, don't give them the attention they want by saying their names.
He obviously can control us. We are dangerous.
Please get these idiots out of our ring.
And we are going to destroy NXT. You will see us again. Want to cut my mic? Is that what you want to do? You just want to cut my mic? That's fine. That's fine. Oh, look.
Get them out of here now.
Come on, guys. Hey, hi. Look, guys, come in the ring. We did what we needed to do. We're here now. We're here now. Get used to it.
Down this way. I'm going right here.
I'm going.
Just rewind.
Okay, we're going. We're going. We're going. Oh, you got the right idea. You got the right idea. I'm going. I'm going.
I can't wait to hear him try to rationalize how he even belongs in the same ring with Bobby Roode.
I've been doing this as long as Bobby Roode has, so some people might think I don't have the right to say this, but it's the truth. The U.S. title needs to be held by someone who's more than just a catchphrase. Because what's truly glorious about that title is its history. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, Bret the Hitman Hart, Sting, Stone Cold Steve Austin, Eddie Guerrero, the American Dream Dusty Rhodes, the Nature Boy Ric Flair, those are just a handful of the legends who were once U.S. champion. And they made that title what it is today because of their amazing battles they had in the ring, not because they just repeated a word over and over again until it caught on. So when I become U.S. champion, I'm going to return the title to its roots. My reign will be about memorable matches, not memorable words, and that will be absolutely glorious!
This should be good.
Let me stop you right there. You come to SmackDown last week, get lucky by winning a battle royal, and then think you can walk out here and say that all I am is a catchphrase?
This title, and that's great, but it's also how this title has been defined.